Minasan, konnichiwa, tamu desu. And welcome to Hikari Online Class. For today's lesson, ipag-aaralan natin ang lesson 25 ng ating grammar discussion. Are you ready? Dewa, hajime masho. Okay, so we will gonna start from the plain past form ra, mean if. Okay, plain past form ra, if. So, when ra is attached to the past tense plain form of verbs, adjective, and etc., it changes the preceding clause into a conditional expression. Okay, so pag nilagay mo si ra sa past tense plain form ng verb, either adjective, so nagiging conditional expression yung kasunod niyang clause. So when a speaker wants to state his opinion, situation, request, etc. in the conditional, this pattern is used. Okay, so pag gusto mong gamitin yung mga opinion mo, yung request, or anything in a conditional, okay, so you use this pattern. Just like the example here, okay? I will travel if I have money. Okay, so yung condition niya, magta-travel siya kung meron siyang pera. So in Japanese, that would be, okane ga attara ryoko shimasu. Okay, okane ga attara ryoko shimasu. Kung ano yung if niya. Okay, so yung I have money. So have is arimas. So, gagawin natin siyang plain past form, which is verb atta and you add ra. That's will be attara ryoko shimasu. Okay? I will travel if I have money. Okane ga attara ryoko shimasu. Another. Yasukattara pasokon wo kaitai desu. I would like to buy a personal computer if it is cheap. Okay? Kung mura lang naman, gusto kong bumili ng sariling or computer. Okay? Yasukattara. Kung mura lang naman, pasoko no kaitainis. Okay? Gusto kong bumili ng personal computer. Another! Jikan ga nakattara TV wo mimasen. I wouldn't watch TV if I didn't have time. I wouldn't watch TV if I didn't have time. Jikan ga nakattara TV wo mimasen. Kung wala lang din naman akong oras, hindi na ako manunood ng TV. Okay? Another. Hima dattara tetsugatte kudasai. Please help me if you have free time. Please help me if you have free time. Hima dattara, kung libre ka lang. Kung libre ka, please help me. Tulungan mo naman ako. Tetsudatte kudasai. Okay, kung free ka lang naman. Okay, so this is giving conditional. Meron ganito, gagawin mo yung preceding clause. Okay? Or kung wala ka nito, hindi mo gagawin si preceding clause. Okay, so that means conditional. Okay, gagawin mo lang si verb if you have that one or if you don't have that one. Okay? So, another is, okay, verb ta formara when or after. So that means this pattern is used to express that a certain action will be done or a certain situation will appear when a matter, action, or stage which is sure to happen in the future has been completed or achieved. So the main sentence is always in the present tense. Okay, kung ano yung main sentence niya is always nating ilalagay or in a present tense. Just like an example here. Let's go out at 10 o'clock. 10時になったら出かけましょう。10時になったら出かけましょう。Okay? So let's go out at 10 o'clock or let's go out when it's 10 o'clock. Lalabas tayo ng alas 10. Okay? Or kung alas 10 na lalabas tayo. Another, I will take a shower as soon as I return to my house. Uchie kai tara. Pag nakauwi na ako, sugu shawa o abemasu. As soon as I got home, or as I return home, I will take a shower. Okay? Maliligo ako agad-agad. Sugu shawa o abemasu. Okay? So the condition is if or kung nakauwi ka na or after you got home. Okay? Yan lang po gagamitin si verb ta form ra. So you can use it when or after. Okay? In the situation or in a conditional way. Next sentence pattern is the verb ta form e adjective na adjective de. So gagawin natin siyang ta form like na e adjective gagawin siyang kote. Then, for na and noun, you will just change it into de for and then add mo. So that be verb temo, kotemo, and demo. So that means even if, kahit na. So this expression is used to present a reverse condition. Okay? So contrary to the plain pasra, this expression is used when an action which is expected to be taken or an event which is expected to be happen naturally under the given circumstance does not materialize or a thing turns out in a way opposite to a socially accepted idea. Okay, kabalik na rin siya nito na kahit na, okay, kahit na hindi ito mangyari, kahit na hindi mangyari yung circumstances or yung mga thing happen in an opposite way, so gagawin mo pa rin si verb, okay? Or si adjective or si noun. So, just like the example here, Amega futemo sentaku shimasu. I do the laundry even if it rains. Okay? Maglalaba pa rin ako kahit na umuulan or uulan. Okay? Another, Benri demo pasuko no tsukaimasen. Okay? I don't use a personal computer even if it's convenient. Okay? Hindi ako gagamit ng computer kahit na magaan ito or convenient ito. Benri de. Since it is a na-adjective, so lalagyan natin siya ng de and we add mo. Benri de mo pasuko no tsukaimasen. Another. Okay? Even if it's cheap, I hate group travel. Yasuku temo watashi wa grupu ryoku ga kirai desu. Yasuku temo watashi wa grupu ryoku ga kirai desu. Okay? So kahit na mura, I still hate group travel. Next and the last one. I work even on Sundays. Nagtatrabaho pa rin ako kahit na Linggo. Nichiyobi demo hatarakimasu. So kahit na Linggo, nagtatrabaho. Okay, so that is how you gonna use the verb temo, i kotemo, or i adjective kotemo, na adjective and noun is demo. That means even kahit na. Okay? Next is mushi and ikura. So mushi is used in a sentence in the plain past form to indicate beforehand that the sentence is going to present a condition. Okay? While ikura is used with temo or demo to do the same. Okay? So ginagamit si mushi is if pa din siya, but it's indicate beforehand or going to the present continuous. While ikura is used with temo and demo. But same lang sila ng function. Okay? So, mushi implies that an emphasis is on the speaker's supposition. While ikura is meant to stress the degree of conditionality. Okay? So, si mushi is implied the supposition of the speaker. While ikura is, yun mas nilalagyan yung bigot ng conditionality ng isang sentence natin or na sinasabi natin. Just like the example here. Okay, what would you do if you had 100 million yen? Mushi, ukuyen attara do shimasu ka? Mushi, ukuyen attara do shimasu ka? If mail ka, 100 million yen, anong gagawin mo? Mushi, 1億円 attara, iruiru na kuni e ryoko shitai desu. If I had 100 yen, I would like to travel to various countries. Okay, so as you can see, ginagamit si Mushi so sa mga situational na iniisip lamang natin. Okay, if meron kang ganito, or if meron kang ganito, okay, so hindi pa siya nangyayari, or mangyayari pa lamang siya. Okay? Next, no matter how much I think about it, I still don't know. Ikura kangaite mo wakarimasen. Ikura kangaite mo wakarimasen. So ikura means no matter how much, kahit gaano ko siya isipin, hindi ko pa rin maintindihan. Ikura kangaite mo wakarimasen. Okay? Another one. No matter how expensive it is, I will buy it. Kahit gaano ka mahal yan, bibilhin ko yan. Ikura takakote mo kaimasu. Ikura takakote mo kaimasu. Kahit gaano ka mahal, bibilhin ko yan. Okay? Yan lang gagamitin si Moshi and ikura. So, ikura is nilalagyan nyo na ako kahit gaano pa yan si verb, si noun, or si adjective. Okay? Well, mushi is, you are giving a situational na hindi pa nangyayari or mangyayari pa lamang. Okay? Another is noun ga. Okay? As mentioned in lesson 16, the subject of a subordinate clause is indicated by ga. Okay, as mentioned in lesson 16, the subject of a subordinate clause is indicated by ga. In subordinate clauses using tara, temo, toki, to, maini, or etc., in addition to kara, the subject is indicated by ga as shown below. Okay, so aside from to kara, so ginagamit din natin si ga. Just like here, I take a day off from work when my wife is ill. Tsuma ga byuki no toki kaisha wo yasumimasu. Tsuma ga byuki no toki kaisha wo yasumimasu. As you can see, hindi natin ginawa si tsuma as wa, but we indicated as a particle ga since we used toki this time. Okay? Okay? 友達が来る前に部屋を掃除します。I clean the room before my friends come. 友達が来る前に部屋を掃除します。So as you can see, ginamit natin si my. Okay, or my ni. So ginawa natin yung subject natin as a particle ga, which is the 友達. Okay, another. 友達が約束の時間に来なかったらどうしますか? 友達が約束の時間に来なかったらどうしますか? What will you do if your friends won't come on time? What will you do if your friends won't come on time? 友達が約束の時間に来なかったらどうしますか? Okay, so friends pa rin yung topic natin or yung subject na sentence natin dito, which is next to jikan. Okay, so ginawa natin siyang particle ga. Okay? So remember that you can use particle ga in the indicated using this sentence pattern or using this tuki, maini, and etc. Okay? So that's the end for our lesson 25. So I hope you learned the vocabularies, the sentence pattern in this lesson. So see you again next time, minasan! Goodbye!